Okay, thank you, sir. This will be over in no time.
How much time remaining? Don't worry, folks. Anything can still happen.
All right. Good job, sir. Thank you.
Remember, folks, that endurance racing is all about getting your car to cover as many miles as possible, no matter how burned out or beat up it may be.
We're here. Food stands here.
Trevor Jones just wants to put California behind him and get on him, stay in the race for as long as possible, and then who knows what might happen.
Miller, I don't care about your problems, all right? I made it clear this morning that if things didn't change, I'd be off the Kronstadt team. Half an hour later, I have to listen to Knox berate my skills as a mechanic because the roll cage interferes with the radio signals from Sierra Soup.
No more.
I'm done. Yes, I know you're a man short now. And no, I don't give a rat's ass about it. You double my salary for the entire week, and I'll come back in case Sierra decides to use that last pit stop. Mm-hmm. Well, if you decide otherwise, I'll be down by the paddock. Best of luck, Grace.
About Thierry? He doesn't do anything.
No. Judging by the state of the car when he brought it back in, I'd say he's not in great condition.
I heard a couple of the guys talking earlier. They said the car was behaving erratically that last lap before the accident. You think anyone, you know, helped make the accident happen?
You! You're the junior slip wrench who got injured yesterday, right?
Suppose I am.
Great, this is your lucky day. Do well and there's a bonus in it. Got it?
Got it.
All right, everyone, look alive and get to your stations. Sierra may come in for a last-minute pit stop, and I need you ready and able. You, rookie, get into position. Grab your preferred tool and be prepared. Today's your day to shine. Let's do this. Sierra's coming in. Everyone on your stations, now!
Get down. Next up, Robert Knox.
What the hell just happened? Sierra!
Oh, no!
Mr. Mack, it's Grace Miller in the Kronstadt pit. Are you watching the feed? It's Sierra.
Look out for the fireworks! Moses Lee! Take the podium in a few moments.
Can you
make sure you have a great meal of celebrations for the stands.
Sorry, for sure.
Well, let's try again. That's what we're doing.
He's a real live wire. Yeah, he turned on the
very likely withholding information on what actually happened in Tongan Valley. And I think I'm going to have a right
to. You know, Robert Knox eats here.
Really? I had no idea it was that good.
Oh, it's good. I mean, I get crazy if I don't sit down here to eat once or twice a week. At one point, when I worked near here, I ate lunch here every day.
He's like a big shot billionaire.
It's true. I was standing in line behind him yesterday. He talked about how he loves this place. Yeah.
Oh, another mechanic.
So, I'm gonna run over and play around with the pyrotechnics for the boarding area.
What? No.
Like all.
All right. He's dressed as a food vendor. Yeah, makes sense, I guess. So he's gonna bring me the stuff? Jesus Christ, woman, it's only sugar, all right? Sugar!
Race is now officially over, and it's time to hand out the trophy to the winner. This year's winner proved that hard work.
Good show, 47. Now stick around. Once the word spreads, Knox won't be long.
With flawless technological execution and persistently excellent driving, this year's winner is undoubtedly the right one. So please join me in giving it a fair. Scout, Heavy Industries, a big hand.
Excuse me. Care for a snack?
Huh? Yes, thank you.
It's nothing.
Smell alone is enough to trigger a massive rush of dopamine.
Who wants a taste? You?
Go ahead. So, what's good?
Everything's to die for, Mr. Knox.
Excellent. Maybe one of these. That was superb, my good man. I'll be back for more in a little while. Just need to stretch my legs.
Okay.
Both targets down. Well done, 47. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon.